throwing that one up there. Ooh.
Hey guys, on our season premiere episode of NBA 2K TV, your favorite community members fill you in on all the new and exciting features of NBA 2K16. We debut NBA 2K TV Interactive, and the reigning MVP and 2K16 cover athlete Steph Curry gives you some shooting tips. You guys don't want to miss this, so tune in now.
Oh, okay.
It's the 2K Sports pregame show.
Hello, basketball fans. Ernie Johnson here, joined by Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. Tonight, two teams start fresh for their first game of the season, both squads believing this will be a great year. Tonight, it'll be the Sacramento Kings up against the Los Angeles Lakers at Staples Center. Looking at the Lakers, they've got the benefit of starting out the season right at home in an atmosphere that's getting ready to explode to celebrate opening night. They are going to be amped to go after win number one. And of course, Freak playing here tonight. You've probably heard his story by now, lost a friend of a long time in the offseason. Very tough to deal with, obviously. How hard is it going to be for him to get his focus back, Shaq?
It's going to be tough, Ernie. He lost someone that he knew for a long time, and it's going to weigh on him. This will be one of his most trying seasons of his career.
Man, I feel for Freak, man. It's not going to be easy. I mean, but it's an opportunity to grow. You know, a lot of guys, Ernie, you put in this position, you know, you just kind of let the court be your refuge, man. Like, this guy is a strong kid. Strong kid.
So well said, Kevin. That does it for us. Kevin Harlan standing by.
Bird's eye view of the Staples Center. Boy, is that gorgeous. The setting for tonight's NBA game. Welcome, everyone, to a brand new season of NBA basketball. I'm sure you're as excited as all of us are here at 2K Sports as we get ready to start the season in style. This is Kevin Harlan along with Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony with Doris Burke reporting on the sidelines. Western Conference battles, always fun. This time it's the Los Angeles Lakers intent on protecting home court. First opportunity here in their inaugural game of the season to go up against Sacramento. They can only manage a single win in four tries against these guys last year.
Yeah, and they lost the season series to this squad. Okay.
The Kings trail by 13. Now Rondo, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. 11 feet away, offensive rebound.
Tell you what, they haven't wasted any time getting into the swing of things on the boards.
And even this early, that's a good omen for the rest of the game. I couldn't have dreamed of a much better start here than they've had today.
I think the offensive game plan they came in with was right on point. It's worked perfectly, and the lead they already have is proof in the pudding.
Let's look at the energy stats, how the hustle game has been going for the Lakers.
Well, in the first half of play, they're closing out aggressively, blocking shots, a key indicator of their activity on the defensive side.
They've gotten their fair share of points off turnovers so far tonight, too.
Clarkson kicks to Freak. Here's Pachulia, and good work on the boards. They pick up the second chance points. Pachulia's got his first points in this one. Now here's Rondo. 34 seconds left in the first. Shot clock at 6. Pass to McLemore. A 3 from Leonard. His shot is good, making him a perfect 2 for 2 from the floor.
Yeah, it's such a sweet 3-point stroke there, and it can really open things up inside, because as good as he shoots it, it forces the opposing bigs to have to step out on the perimeter.
Here's Clarkson. Shot is off. Good D by Rondo. In the corner, it's McLemore. It's deflected. And as the first quarter wraps up, already a double-digit lead. Lakers lead by 15. And the second quarter about to get started. We'll be back in just a moment. We sat down with Freak to discuss how he's handling the loss of his close friend.
You know, Vic was my brother. Blood couldn't have made us any closer. And everything feels like it just happened yesterday. So I'm just trying to take things one day at a time, you know? I'm very grateful for my family, my teammates and coaches for supporting me during this difficult season. I miss Vic, but I'll press on. Yeah.
Our thoughts and prayers go out to Freak Clark and his family.
Without question, I mean, it's a really difficult road to navigate the loss of a loved one or a close friend. And sometimes, even though it's difficult with that kind of weight on your heart, the focus you have to give to the game can sometimes be a source of solitude, because you really can't be thinking about anything else when you get between those lines. And sometimes that can be helpful in the process of moving forward.
Well said. Your perspective is always appreciated.
Appreciate that, Kevin.
Welcome back, folks. We'll see if we're in store for a more tightly contested quarter as we move here into the second. And guys, the Lakers enjoying a nice lead here.
Well, they've dictated tempo with their defense and been able to force some turnovers.
Yeah, and you know, they've also done a good job, Greg, on their end of the floor by not throwing the ball away.
On the court for Sacramento, Rajon Rondo is out there with McLemore. Then there's Caspi. Then there's Cauley-Stein. And it's Leonard in at the four slot. Here's Reyes, and the whistle blows. It's going to be on Ben McLemore. That'll be his second foul of the game.
Another foul would give him three before the half. Something to keep an eye on, guys.
And the Lakers making a change here. Bass is checked in. Then for the Kings, DeMarcus Cousins. He's checked in for Cauley-Stein. Quincy Azy's come in for Myers Leonard. And Rudy Gay is subbed in for Caspi. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. For Los Angeles, they have gone 7 of 9 from the free throw line tonight.
Yeah, and fairly decent a season ago, about 77% from the line.
And you know, a lot of times, guys, in some of their performances last year, their free throw numbers helped them win games.
First one falls for him. Kobe's checked in for the Lakers. And both free throws good for Clarkson. We play just over a minute of basketball here in the second quarter. Rondo kicks to Gay. Back to Rondo. An easy layup after coming off the pick. Rondo's got his first bucket of the night.
Nice work on the inside. Hard to get that one up and over the big fella.
Well, it's not supposed to be easy down there, and a little artistry on the inside helped him make it happen.
And he gets it to go. And the Lakers lead by 17.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Well, I agree with you. Four of their last five baskets have been exactly of that variety.
Kicks it to McLemore. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. Clarkson dishes to Freak. There's the pick. Off the pick. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. Well, a bit of a tragic note for Freak. He'll be playing this season after the loss of a longtime friend over the summer break.
Yeah, that's hard to hear, and certainly going to be difficult for him to work through that. Going to be on his mind all year. Never easy to go on about business as usual when you have that kind of heartache and loss.
Here's what the Lakers are going with right now. Roy Hibbert's checked in for Pachulia. And it's Russell in for Jordan Clarkson. Here's Semenko, the rim-rattling two-handed jam.
Boy, I love that sweet up fake, Kevin. It worked like a charm there and gave him a clear path to the lane and then to the hoop.
Well, that move is one of the prettiest out there if you can pull it off. And a wide-open look for Freak. Good, and the assist goes to Russell. Russell's got his third assist on the night.
And I like the fact that he really was unfazed by that scoreless first quarter, and now you can see him getting into a rhythm.
I want you to focus on getting to the rim. Let's look to attack quickly. We need high percentage shots. Move the ball around and make the defense rotate.
Drew Williams is checked in. Both teams making substitutions here. Los Angeles has gone 2-of-4 from three-point range so far in the second quarter.
Move the ball.
Clarkson with the ball.
Stick it too much.
He has six. Teardrop shot, and it's good on the way in. Clarkson's got 6 points in the quarter.
Boy, have they got hot here in the second quarter. No wonder they're in front.
I don't know if this field goal percentage is sustainable, but if they can stay close to what they've done in shooting the ball, they'll run away with this one. And that'll increase their rebound advantage. They've definitely been winning that battle on the boards.
You know what? No rebounds, no rings, and they've controlled the boards, and that's what's given them control of this game.
And he gets it to go.
They're hovering around 50% for the game in three-pointers. That's pretty good. But they've really elevated here in the second quarter.
And the pass to Rondo. Over to the left wing. A drive by Collison gets that one to drop. First one of the game after four straight misses.
Wow, got that one off right in the face of the big fella. Nice quick fire release.
Yeah, and the mid-range shot really the only option in that situation. Sometimes when you're facing a bigger guy, you can't get it all the way to the rim.
Doing a really good job from the line here. Just under 90%, actually right around 86, 87% from the stripe.
Shooting from Los Angeles, Zaza Pachulia. Taking two shots.
That one is off. And he's good on the second. Sacramento's got nothing but zeros from long range in the second quarter. 0-of-4. And Caspi kicks to Collison. No good from outside.
And another miss. Ooh, he's having a really ugly game.
Yeah, about as ugly as you can have, you're right.
Move the ball. Stick it.
And here's Clarkson. 8 points for him. Here's the screen. Shot clock at six. From the high post, it's rebounded by Leonard.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that open.
Barnes against Rondo. He dishes it to Cousins. Shot is off. And so a pretty lopsided game through the first half. Lakers on top, running away with it. Stay with us, folks. We'll get back just after halftime to start the third quarter.
All right, guys, great first half. Home fans are loving it. Still want to go over a couple of things, though. All right.
And as we welcome you back, we begin our second half. So far, not a tightly contested game, guys, but, you know, anything can happen. You look at Freak in this game, he has been everywhere.
And his play in that first half, how about the discipline to go along with the efficiency, guys? His shot selection was just perfect.
I agree. I mean, whether it's been from mid-range or in tight, he is taking only what the defense is giving him and not trying to do too much, very much playing within himself.
Lakers shooting 52% from the floor. Nice work so far from them.
Reyes
in at point guard. Mahimi is out there with Randall. Then there's Kobe. And it's Brown in at the three spot. That's who's in the game for the Lakers.
That's a shot he shouldn't be afraid to take more often.
Passes it to Cousins. Back to Collison. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two. Julius Randle picks one up. And a moment now to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from here for the Lakers.
A lot of times when they needed some easy points in this game, they've been able to get to the foul line and get them.
Another part of their game that's made a difference tonight is all the second chance points they've been able to get.
And the Lakers making a change here. Pass is checked in. And both free throws good for Darren Collison. The Lakers with the ball. Freak kicks to Bryant. Here's Reyes. A strong finish under heavy pressure all over.
Really, the defense is helpless to stop a layup right there. Just too much of an advantage in terms of the mismatch.
Outside Collison. Six to shoot. Who's checked in for Darren Collison.
Into the lineup of the Kings.
Just over a minute played here in the fourth. Here's Semenko. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
That's really told the story today, guys. I mean, throughout this game, they've been able to get the ball in tight and then finish.
More active and more physical down low. That's what's really been the difference thus far.
And the Kings pushing it up now. Here's Daniel. Lead pass was put in just the right spot.
And just a step ahead of the D in that possession there, making the pass. Nice assist.
Freak kicks to Brown. The jump hook, and Bryant finishes inside.
I really think that's the area they want to work the ball into, and it takes passing like that to get it done.
We're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter in this one. Here's Bellinelli, defended by Bryant. Bryant with the rebound.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
Guys, that's putting it mildly. I mean, they've been absolutely dominant.
Here's Bellinelli, defended by Bryant. Now Bellinelli. Shot clock at five. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Mahimi's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. And Kobe the bucket with the assist by Brown. 16 points for Kobe Bryant.
Almost uncontested. I mean, it's nice to be able to add to the lead without having to really work for it.
Here's Kufis, and the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line. And the Lakers with some changes. Pachulia, he's checked in for Bass. And it's Barnes in for Bryant. And a change for the Kings. Leonard's checked in. Reyes, the pass to Pachulia. Barnes dishes to Freak. Misses in close.
Oh, that's terrific defense there. That's how you protect the rim.
With the teardrop, no good from Caspi.
There was just enough defensive pressure to get him off balance and cause that shot to go awry.
Here's Reyes, and another basket for the Lakers.
I love his shot selection today. He set the bar for the rest of the team.
For Sacramento, they've gone 3 of 6 from the field so far in the fourth quarter. There's a good screen. Outside, Leonard takes a three. No luck, and it's the Lakers the other way. Ball stolen. And here comes Bellinelli leading the fast break.
Well, that fast break went according to plan.
Yeah, nice job there, Greg. Recognizing the opportunity was there to push it, and then excellent execution.
Freak sets a screen for Brown, and play stops. Whistle on what looks to be an illegal screen.
Seems to me as though he's lost his way a little bit in the second half. He'd been turnover free before the break. That's certainly not the case anymore.
Sacramento's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Semenko, he's guarded by Reyes. Here's Semenko. It's rebounded by Reyes.
Their game plan needs to change if they're going to get out of this hole, because he is just not there offensively. Just too dangerous of a shooter to leave alone from beyond the arc.
The Kings have gotten just under 45% of their attempts to drop in the fourth. 4 of 9. A floater. The shot by Bellinelli. No good.
And fancy finish. Like that look great, but man, it's embarrassing when you blow. And that's just carelessness there. I mean, you have got to have your head in the game.
The Kings shooting 34% from the field. That's not going to get it done. Pass to Caspi. Dishes it to Bellinelli. Six on the shot clock. Here's Kufis, and he banks in the layup.
They are not rotating nearly quickly enough on defense down low. Got to get quicker there.
Just no resistance on the interior.
Picked away. He's got a clear path by himself. Rips down the breakaway slam.
How about the quick hands on the steal and the quick feet on the break?
Yeah, a careless, silly mistake there, though. I mean, coughing the ball up and then not being quick enough to get back on defense, that's costly.
Here is Mahimi. Pachulia kicks to Freak. And there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
Certainly that shot well within his range.
I would hope so.
And especially when he caps it off with the steady one-hand jam.
Out left to the wing. Here is Caspi, covered by Barnes. Here's Kufis, and again it's Sacramento converting.
Just a major size difference between the defender and shooter on that possession.
And Greg, without a hand in his face, he's simply going to spray whoever's there.
Here's Reyes, powered down with both hands.
Make it two hands for safety. That's what they say, right, Kevin?
Yeah, that's right. You got it. And he was ultra safe with that dunk.
No reason not to be.
And guys, as he should be, remove all doubt on that attack.
Semenko, he's covered by Reyes. There's the dish to Bellinelli. Leonard with a screen on Brown. Six on the shot clock. Here's Bellinelli, and it's wide right. Hits off the rim. The Lakers have gone 8 of 10 from the field here in the fourth quarter. Really getting it done.
Some fantastic numbers here for Freak. He has 20 points, and he's picked up 6 points from behind the arc.
I love the rhythm his outside stroke has produced today.
Three at the line for two. free throw good. Freak. Russell, he's checked in for the Lakers. The Kings also with the sub. Rondo's checked in. And both free throws good from Freak. Here's Rondo. He feeds it to Bellinelli. Let's it go with a three. Rebound by Mahimi. Mahimi's got rebound number 7 for him tonight.
You can see the frustration in the quarter on his face, especially with his team trailing.
Here's the screen. Freak dishes to Pachulia. Inside, Russell. The shot is off. Now Sacramento takes it the other way. Next up on the schedule, the Grizzlies. That'll be a home game. And that's the first game in a string of 3 straight at home.
I tell you what, he earned his money on that foul.
Yeah, if you're going to foul, then make sure that you don't give a chance for the and one.
And both free throws good for Caspi. Guys, we have seen them with a lot of good ball movement.
Well, you like the smooth operating they're showing you here. I mean, things are clicking, and more importantly, it makes them tough to defend.
Mark, what you know about Sade? Smooth operator. But I agree with you. I think we're all seeing that right now.
Yes, indeed.
You don't need much range to hit from that distance, Kevin.
To the left wing. They set the screen. He kicks it to Bellinelli. Feeds to Leonard. Kings moving the ball around. 4 on the clock. Pass to Bellinelli. Charity stripe shot. That's good, and it's Leonard with the assist.
Easy little jumper for him right there, guys.
This has been a one-sided affair.
Yeah, they've done a nice job of extending their lead and maintaining that intensity level.
There's the triple. It's hauled in by the Kings. Now here's Rondo. Inside. A nice shot by Kufis. Kufis has got 8 points in the quarter.
And that keeps him perfect from the field this quarter.
Russell with it. There's a good screen. Let's a floater go, and it's good on the way in.
Uh-oh, a little showboating at the end of that one.
Sacramento's gone 0-3 so far in the fourth quarter from long range. The drive by Rondo. Kufis. Oh, yes, he did. 5 up and 5 down for him so far.
That's the 3rd straight make off an assist.
Great ball movement.
Outside, Russell. Pachulia the pass to Reyes. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot 2.
Clearly a foul.
Yeah, he took a shot there. Earned those free throws.
At the line for your Lakers. Free! At the line for 2.
Free throw good. Freak. Brandon Bass has checked in for Ian Mahimi. And the Kings making a change here. And both free throws good from Freak. So it's Sacramento now. And here's Rondo. Leonard with a screen on Russell. Rondo kicks to Leonard. And it's good coming on the assist by Rajon Rondo. Rondo's got 5 assists in the game. Los Angeles has gone 1-2 from 3-point range here in the fourth. Now here's Freak. Bellinelli is covering. Freak dishes to Russell. Clock at 6 to the middle. And that one's good. Freak. Freak's got 14 points now in the second half.
I don't think they can ask much more of him than what he's done this quarter.
Rondo kicks to Bellinelli. Over to the wing. Caspi for 3. But they'll get another chance.
And the rebounding has been key to their success here tonight.
It has been a lopsided battle on the boards, no doubt.
Russell passes to Reyes. The feed to Pachulia. To the paint. That's a two from Barnes. They get it again. Reyes, a beautiful reverse layup. Freaks got 28.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for the Lakers.
When you consider the difference in their field goal percentages, the other team has to be happy that this wasn't a bigger loss. This team was on fire.
Yeah, you know what, Kevin? It's got to be frustrating to shoot so poorly when the other team is on fire.
And it'll go down as their first official win of the new year.
And asserting themselves right from the start, guys, they'll be taking the front end of a four-game season series between these two clubs. They've got to feel good getting the upper hand tonight against the Kings.
And what a huge standout performance it was for Freak. He was doing everything right, and the points came in bunches. Definitely had the hot hand. Not really his best quarter as far as scoring. Let's see if he can eventually get back on track.
Good, and the assist goes to Russell. And that's now 30 points for Freak.
And just a terrific job of taking care of business in front of the home fans.
And, Greg, those fans had a hand in the win. I mean, they gave this team a big lift throughout the game. I thought there was great energy in the building. Rondo, a master at setting up teammates.
Five-second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Russell dishes to Pachulia. Now here's Freak. He's covered closely. Outside, Russell. From deep. Rebound by Caspi. And so it's the Lakers taking care of business here. They poured it on tonight, Clark. A dominant showing in front of a crowd that loved every minute of it.
I don't think they have anything but positives to take away from this win. Offensively, defensively, every aspect of the game, it all went right for them.
And that about does it for the first game of the new NBA season. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan along with our entire 2K sports crew. Thanking you for tuning in. And we'll see you next time. But first, the post-game show with Ernie Johnson just a few aisles above us.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Thank you, Kevin. And now we have the opportunity to present our Jordan player of the game, Freak. The fourth quarter was all him. It was like he couldn't miss, and it was just one basket after another.
Seeing Freak dominate the way he did tonight reminded me of watching him play in high school. He was a man among boys. He was a four-time consensus All-American back then. Overall, great game.
He was dead on from the field tonight, guys. I'd call his performance economical because there was no wasted opportunities. He took advantage of every good look he got. I mean, everything he put up was going in.
And that's it for our broadcast here tonight. But we're just getting started on a new season in the NBA. For Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith, Kevin Harlan, and the entire 2K Sports crew, I'm Ernie Johnson. We'll see you again soon.
When did you know it was going to be one of those nights on the offensive end for you?
After I saw a few shots go down, it was pretty clear I was in a good rhythm. And then it just kind of snowballed from there. Next.
Critics might say you were just chasing numbers in a game tonight that was clearly in hand. Agree or disagree?
You know I don't agree with that. I'm going to play hard whenever coach puts me out there. And that's all there is to it. It's not about numbers or anything else. It's about the win and the fact that I give 100% on the court no matter the score or the opponent. Look, that's just how I'm wired.
You went through a lot last year as you got acclimated to being in the NBA. And then you went through a tough time in the offseason with the death of your childhood friend, Victor. Can you explain your mindset to us as you try to move forward this season?
You're right. It's definitely been a challenging year. My rookie season, it all seems like a blur now. Losing Vic, that was one of the hardest things I've ever dealt with in my life. But I'm here now, in a great situation for me to grow my game. And my focus on the game of basketball. 100%, 10 times 10. And I'm gonna do whatever I can to bring this team a championship. But that's all I got. Thank you.